Why is my husband looking at pornography? I get that question quite a bit over the last 30 years. I remember getting emails from Africa, Europe, Asia, all over the world. Dr. Weiss, why is he looking at pornography when he has me? So stay tuned. We're gonna address that question. Now, if you have not subscribed, hit the button, subscribe, so you can watch the other videos we've done and be notified of other things that we're doing, so that you can get information free and it might help your life. If you have a question, I want to hear that. Put it in the comment box below here. I want to hear your question. Stay tuned. Why is my husband looking at pornography? That doesn't make sense to a lot of ladies because they've never looked at pornography. They have no idea, or they haven't. It's like no big deal. Why would he want to look at pornography? And in some cases, look at pornography and not even be sexual with me. Now, he could be struggling with intimacy anorexia. If he is, then that's going to be a severe problem. Or he could have a sex addiction. All right, but why? Well, let me tell you, it has nothing to do with you, ma'am. Nothing at all. It's not about your body. It's not about your age. It's not about your sex life. It's not about having a gray hair. It's something else. In most cases, now before I say any of this, let me preface this. I've been working with men with sexual addiction and porn addiction for over 30 plus years. I have taken more masturbation and porn histories than probably any man on the planet. I've been doing that my entire career, looking at how these men in their 40s, 50s, and 60s are addicted to pornography, why they're looking at pornography. And with the access on their cell phones, the internet, their iPads, it's everywhere. I mean, it is in the air 24/7 to be downloaded. But why would they do that? We have a good sex life. You know, I'm in shape, I look good. A lot of the ladies I work with who come with these men are very attractive, intelligent, full package ladies, or they're good moms, even good lovers, and yet these men are looking at pornography. Doesn't make sense. Well, let's go back in history. Oftentimes, these men have formed their sexuality attaching to the object world, the fantasy world, and pornography world. They found Uncle Joe's porn in the garage, or their dad's, or the next door neighbor's. And what happens is when you have a sexual release, like an orgasm, you get these endogenous opiates, hits the prefrontal cortex of your brain, and boom, you get this huge chemical release, but you get also this attachment to whatever you're looking at. Now, most of these guys started at 12, 13, 14 years old or younger, and by the time they're even married, they have masturbated to pornography at least 1,000 times, if not many more thousand times, and they keep doing this over the course of their marriage. And so there's this neuropathic attachment to the object world. I call her boo-boo mommy. And then there's the relational sex with you, if they're being relational during sex with you. Now, if they're closing their eyes and going to another world, they're not with you, they're connecting to something else, and they're reinforcing actually an object in their sexuality. And so that's part of why they look at pornography. Sometimes they give psychological meanings to the pornography, feeling wanted, feeling powerful, feeling in control, feeling creative, feeling celebrated. And there's a psychological voice, that profile they've created in their mind, because when they go to the fantasy world, they are worshipped and adored and wanted, and there's no rules, and they don't have to pick up the garbage, they don't have to take the trash out, they don't have to do dishes, they're not dealing with, you know, kids and a wife that's tired. They're dealing with some imaginary, energetic person who is nothing on their mind but sex and has no needs whatsoever, doesn't have to orgasm, doesn't have to in any way get ready. There's no reality. And they have attached thousands of times to this world. And to be honest, it's easier than a relationship. So they take the easy way, they get the chemical high, and oftentimes this produces a sexual addiction. If he's looking at pornography, there's more than a good chance that there's a sex addiction there going on. And there's help, he can get help. There's the book, The Final Freedom, that can help you. There's the book, The Six Types of Sex Addicts, can help him understand what type he is. There's help for you. Here's what our research shows. If you're living with someone with sex addiction, you've gone through trauma, okay? And that affects you in many ways. If you go to partnerbetrayaltrauma.org, there's a lot of information there on what's happening with you. But the reasons he's looking at it, biological attachment, okay? Psychological attachment to the voices. Oftentimes family of origin issues where their needs weren't met, so they went to the fantasy world and got their needs met. Chemical imbalances can also be another reason. Whether it's depression, bipolar, manic depression, or psychothymic disorder, they could be using the sexual release to help balance their brain, okay? That could be another reason. And then intimacy anorexia, where they're avoiding intimacy with the real person and they go to the fantasy world. So any of those could be the reasons. But did you notice you were not one of those reasons? Not in any way is he looking at pornography because of you. It wouldn't have mattered who he married. This thing was going to happen because it's already been set up many years before you met him. Oftentimes, this secret's been going on for decades before it even gets caught. So, if you're in this situation, there is help. I'm the executive director of Heart to Heart Counseling Center here in Colorado Springs. Call our office and we can do intensives, maybe a phone session, whatever you need for you if he doesn't want to get better, or at least talk through what's going on, because the trauma of this happening to you can be severe. So please, at least take some steps for you. And if he wants to get better, we got lots of information and materials for him to get better. Now, you might have a question, so please feel free to write it. I will personally respond to you as quickly as I can. And the subscribe button, because there's other information you might want that we've already done, or there's new information coming and we'll get it to you and you'll get a little alert that, hey, Dr. Doug is sharing something else just for you. Now, if you are a wife of someone looking at pornography, I want to invite you to go to our Facebook group, Partners of Sex Addicts, and join that. That can be truly helpful. Okay, there's a lot of resources for you. So please, take your next step.